coverage tonight of the 2012 Discover Orange Bowl. West Virginia on top 63-26. The pictures from above provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned, making tires that go the distance, inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven. Mike Tirico, John Gruden, Ron Jaworski, Lisa Salter's on the sideline. See what West Virginia's future will be and where it will be in the Big 12 or longer in the Big East. They will represent the conference well if it's their last game in the Big East, as they have the other two times in BCS games.
And I see Stedman Bailey, their star wide receiver, back in the game here at the bottom of the screen. Number three got hurt earlier. Good to see him back.
All those records. No wonder Bailey's been cramping up here in this third quarter. Screen set up to start the fourth with Bowie. And his third down gain will come up shy. And West Virginia will kick it away. 63 points, not just a BCS record, but also an Orange Bowl record. Alabama scored 61, beating Syracuse in the 1953 Orange Bowl.
I know that hurt you to mention that, Mike.
West Virginia had 63 points in 34 minutes. So
yeah,
that's a difference. Put that in your asterisk somewhere.
Sammy Watkins back to return. Hasn't been the kind of a breakout night equal of the talents of Watkins. Is West Virginia's defense has done a pretty good job. There's an interesting story in that regard that we'll get into on the other side of the break. 50 seconds into the fourth. South Beach calls. SportsCenter will follow our post-game coverage, trophy presentation. Mountaineers on top by 37. West Virginia, sixth straight year they finished 5-2 in the Big East. And we're the co-champions of the league as Taj Boyd spins and turns shy of the 40. One of the good West Virginia performances over these last few years. Jeff Castile has some responsibility for it. Defensive coordinator, been in Morgantown for over a decade now. A very unique defense as well.
Yes, it is. Learned this from old Joe Lee Dunn, the old Mississippi State coach. Helped them find a niche in recruiting. They weren't able to find those premier defensive tackles, so they went to the 3-3-5. And it's a flexible front. It gives them some versatility in coverage. It's good against these spread offenses. And Coach Castile is rumored to be possibly reuniting with Coach Rich Rodriguez, who went to Arizona. Got to keep an eye on this Jeff Castile. I know they want to keep him in Morgantown. It's been a big part of their success for a long time.
Adam Humphreys, a freshman, comes up shy of the first down, just shy of the 45.
Another one of those freshmen that Clemson really likes. They have a very young football team, and you're out of practice watching Adam Humphreys, and coaches were talking about. A little Wes Welker-like as well. Young guy with a big upside.
Taj Boyd going downfield towards his tight end, Dwayne Allen. That's incomplete. We get a flag thrown on the coverage. Dwayne Smith over there.
You mentioned Wes Welker a lot tonight. You know, it must be showing everyone how critical that position is, that inside runner, inside catching the ball, over the ball in the hash area. Gotta be
pass
tough.
Interference. Defense number 24, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Ian Smith didn't like the call there.
Play in the West Virginia rally at the end of the season. Block a field goal against Cincinnati. Mountaineers, very tight end of the year, winning three close games at the end. Come from behind fashion to share the Big East title. Incomplete. Keith Candy, all conference corner, had a hand on it.
West Virginia, here comes number 11 back in the ball game. Bruce Irvin, that's another good sign. West Virginia has rushed three men on about the last 15 snaps. This is a prevent defense, loaded zone coverages. They are not going to let Clemson have anything over the top. They're going to make them work for every inch and see if this three-man pass rush can get the boy.
The second and 10, Taj is intercepted by Tandy. 13th of his Mountaineer career. In his final game in the WVU blue and gold, Keith Tandy with a pick.
Well, Tandy played it beautifully. Just kept expanding and expanding. Squeezed that window down for Boyd. Boyd tried to throw it in there. Just didn't have any opportunity. You'll see number 8 do a great job. That's Keith Tandy. Just keep moving back. Look at the quarterback's eyes. Locate the football and garner the interception.
You have to wonder about Boyd right there. He's turned the ball over now 3 times. He's really struggled down the stretch this season taking care of the football. And sometimes when you get a young quarterback with too much confidence, bad things happen. But that's a terrible decision in any situation.
Well, John, you had mentioned they were rushing 3, dropping 8. Sometimes you got to just take those checkdowns and methodically work the ball down the field rather than force throws. I know the score indicates you got to take some chances, but you pay the price when you throw in the coverage.
Delay of game. Offense number 12. 5-yard penalty. The down remains first.
Dabo Swinney did something as an offensive guy that isn't always easy. He gave complete autonomy, and he was a wide receiver coach for his many years at Clemson and Alabama before that. He gave complete autonomy of the offense to Chad Morris when he came in. Has become more of a CEO head coach. Tavon Austin still running, still going. Austin having a phenomenal bowl performance, MVP bowl performance, shy of midfield.
You know, Mike, Clemson didn't play well tonight, but Dabo Swinney's an outstanding coach. You're around this guy, you talk to his players, people around the Clemson program, they know this guy has his team moving in the right direction. They're a young team. You know, this was disappointing tonight, but they'll learn from it. Bubble screen, bubble screen, bubble screen. Very effective tonight for West Virginia.
Look at Austin. 11 catches, 117 yards, and 100 of it is after the catch. That's hard to believe if that's accurate. Yeah, well, I've never seen that before.
Well, it's all the, you know, all the short passes.
He got 117 yards and 100 after the catch.
Well, every one of his touchdowns was like a 1-yard throw. It's a shovel pass.
You were just complaining about it, John.
I don't know how you tackle this kid. He's a joker in this offense. They put him in the backfield. They've used him in the slot. They've used him as a return man. He's one of the top 5 all-purpose yardage leaders in the country. It's great that he had this platform tonight to show his stuff to America. He's coming back next year. West Virginia could be real exciting on offense again.
Could be. They will be.
The prism of what kind of a national impact they would have certainly changes if you end up in the Big 12 compared to the Big East. Was Sean Alston with the carry. He gets to the 35-yard line.
You have to wonder where this front 4 of Clemson is tonight. It just comes storming off that right side, right at Clemson.
You got Andre Branch and Brandon Thompson, a couple defensive linemen projected as first-round picks. Been invisible for the most part tonight. Give credit to that West Virginia offensive line. They have been stout.
Alston toward the left for about a gain of 4. But guys, you mentioned Dana Holgerson, injured Mountaineer here. And their center, second team all Big East center, Joe Madsen. Timeout for him for a second. He's limping off. Well, you mentioned Dana Holgerson and where he's been over the last few years with Houston for a couple of seasons. With Case Keenum, and Keenum this year led football bowl subdivision in passing yards. And then Brandon Whedon was 3rd. He was with Whedon at Oklahoma State before coming to West Virginia. Geno Smith 6, so Holgerson's hands on 3 of the top 6 quarterbacks in passing yards per game this year. Madsen back down on the ground for a moment. Athletic trainer's out to look at him, so we'll step out for a second.
ESPN College Football, the Discover Orange Bowl, is brought to you by Discover, the official card of the Discover Orange Bowl. The Ford F-150, available with the efficiency and power of EcoBoost. And Taco Bell, think outside the bun.
We're back in South Florida as the injured player Joe Madsen limped off with the training staff. West Virginia leading 63-26 here in the Discover Orange Bowl. The actual building itself, known as the Orange Bowl, will be a baseball stadium later on this year as the Florida Marlins open in their new facility in that stadium. Here's Tavon Austin by the Miami Marlins. Passing complete. Miami Marlins' brand new beautiful stadium that will open coming up here at the March, start of April. That old Orange Bowl is one of the great stadiums of all time. Memorable games, memorable Orange Bowls themselves. But that place rocked.
It looked like an erector set when you went up to it. Like. Did have some history, though.
Great memories and great moments. Decades. Stedman Bailey, the catch. Out of an arm tackle and a first down at the 22-yard line as we're under 10 minutes.
Look at that Orange Bowl. Joe Namath, his name came up a couple times tonight. That's where he led his New York Jets to a Super Bowl victory. The Baltimore Colts. This turned around the face of professional football. The landscape of professional football changed after that game.
This is the game that America found out a bit more about Joe Namath. The 65 Orange Bowl lost to Texas. Got to come from behind.
Rallied his team, but didn't get it done.
Joe Namath, if you're listening, your ears are probably burning. If they're not, we talked about you a lot today.
West Virginia still has a chance to set the record for most points in a bowl game by a team. Wow. Tavon Austin stopped on a dime and got restarted.
You see what he did to Breland right there? He just shows you so much creativity whenever he touches the ball. Dana Holgorsen said when he has the ball, he's just magnificent. They'd like to see him improve without the ball in his hands. But watch this move against Breland, number 17. I don't know if Breland touches him.
Barely.
This hard to coach that
guy. Wow. He's not your favorite player, huh, John?
He is tonight. He's my MVP.
From Bar High School, Baltimore, Maryland. Had 11 catches for 187 yards against LSU, against Morris Claiborne and Tyrann Mathieu. An outstanding secondary. Alston stopped a couple yards shy of the first down.
Clemson just hasn't tackled well at all tonight, Mike. That time another missed tackle in the hole. And sometimes with these long layoffs, you can use it as an excuse. I don't think the tackling will be real shoddy when LSU plays Alabama. The two best tackling teams I've seen in college football in a while.
Clemson came out here a couple days early to get some extra work in, and certainly hasn't paid off.
Watch, they're going to come storming out of this huddle inside of 7 seconds. So many different tempos that they can run, Mike.
Alston up the middle of the first down as he's looking for a third touchdown run on the night.
This is what Dana Holgorsen has added to his repertoire. When he left Texas Tech, they were a high octane offense. But when he went to Houston, he put it in a no huddle environment. And watch him come out of this huddle. They're going to milk this clock all the way down to about 12 seconds. And they're going to come storming out of here together and then snap the ball quickly. It's another form of this Dana Holgorsen tempo. Watch this. They're going to use all this clock. Here they come.
You see the clock tick down, 11.
Clemson
10.
Can't line up.
Alston runs to the 7. It's a much different method in pro football with the helmet communication from the play caller to the quarterback. So here it has to be a series of hand signals or wristbands. With Holgorsen, it's hand signals.
There's no wristbands on Geno Smith's arms at all. It's all hand signals, and that gives the receivers the formation. They'll get the play. Geno will echo it to the offensive lineman.
And on the defensive side, you've got to watch and wait to see what they're doing and try to make a call. And you have to have a veteran, experienced guy to help make the calls on the field on his own to maximize your impact. Lob for the end zone for Bailey. Incomplete with Sensabaugh covering.
Sensabaugh's done a nice job all night.
Yep.
they've got most of their work done on the other side. Here's Sensabaugh one-on-one with Bailey. Nice job with his inside hand. Wheels his head around. Excellent coverage by Sensabaugh. I like him.
You know, we're starting to see in the NFL some of these speed offense pass concepts that we see now at the collegiate level. You look at New Orleans and Atlanta and New England. That speed offense, very effective. Some of these things that we're seeing at the collegiate level now, the pros are starting to pick up. Some good things happening at this level. Here's your play, John.
Willie Milhouse on the flip and into the record books, West Virginia. The highest scoring bowl game in history.
Is that a touchdown pass?
Yeah, that's a touchdown pass, John. This play may go to the Hall of Fame after this game. This thing has worked all night long against this Clemson defense.
Wow, five touchdown passes that haven't been thrown out of the backfield. I mean, that's like playing patty cake in the backyard with your son. Unbelievable how that play has just ruined Clemson's bowl experience.
And Geno Smith has set a new BCS record, and we say this with a smile and a wink. Six touchdown passes in a game, most in a BCS game.
You and John are winking.
A bowl record, you've never seen that in the postseason. 70 points.
Coming soon, baby. It's here,
showtime.
Yeah.
It was quite a show put on by the junior from Dunbar High School, Baltimore, Maryland, Tavon Austin. And second in the nation in all-purpose yards, and even on this hard-to-keep-your-footing turf, Austin made those trademark moves that we've seen all year and has helped lead West Virginia to a record-setting performance tonight, 70 points. .280 all-purpose yards and four touchdowns. His name being written down as the MVP ballots being passed out to members of the media. Rob Brown able to, for the second time tonight, keep a return alive and take it to the 45-yard line. So Monday night, we'll wrap up the college season, the game for it all. Crystal ball will be handed out. I think the Superdome's going to be any kind of crazy. Number one LSU, number two Alabama. The toast of the All-State BCS National Championship game on ESPN, ESPN 3D. Watch ESPN app and ESPN radio coverage all week. College football live down there with Chris Fowler, Todd Blackledge, Kirk Herbstreit down there today with the guys, David Pollock, Desmond Howard, Todd McShay. Everybody be down there. I look forward to joining them this weekend. Quite a weekend in New Orleans, guys. Saints have their playoff game on Saturday at the All-State Sugar Bowl a couple of nights ago. Last night. And the championship game on Monday.
That Saints offense is really rolling right now. And it, guys, not quite like West Virginia, but they're rolling.
Dodge boy throwing on the run. It was almost 77 and 7 going back the other way.
Yeah, Boyd has really struggled clearly with this 3-5-3 defense here in the second half. And I mean a three-man rush. Five underneath, three deep, two deep, six underneath, mixed up coverages. Young quarterback clearly struggling right now.
Redshirt sophomore committed to West Virginia. He throws an incompletion on third down. He committed March 2008, and in watching the offense, the way that was progressing, Boyd decommitted, was going to end up going to Tennessee, and then they were having their coaching change and felt that with Phil Fulmer leaving there, the offense that he was looking for didn't fit his wants, with Lane Kiffin coming in more of a pro-style offense. So he visited Oregon, visited Ohio State. Dabble Swinney got in late in the process, able to get Boyd to come to Death Valley. And he's done a good job setting offensive records this year at Clemson, but tonight a big-time struggle. Down at the 7 with 5:38 remaining. The Discover Orange Bowl, record-setting night for the Mountaineers. This game has set the record for the most combined points in any of the BCS bowls. And he's seen a lot of it. The great views tonight, courtesy of the DirecTV Ultimate Picture Cam. And that's been the guy who's been a pleasure to watch. Fast speed, slow-mo, super slow-mo. Tavon Austin.
Stole the show tonight, didn't he?
Hard to believe he only had four touchdowns receiving this year. And one rushing, four here tonight. Drew Bowie popping pads and taking it out to the 18-yard line.
This is a 175-pound back. See if you can just hear the pads pop.
Oh. He's playing like it's the first play of the game. You got to love that out of this young man. This late in the game, playing hard, knocking people down.
He's a freshman. Whew. Everybody's coming back here in West Virginia.
It'll be interesting to see if the Mountaineers end up in the Big 12 sooner or later. How much will it impact their recruiting base? They've long been a school to use Maryland, Ohio, Pennsylvania, Western PA, just an hour drive from Pittsburgh on I-79 in Morgantown.
It's a pretty fertile recruiting area there, Mike. I don't know, lie, you know, West Virginia is very successful there, but you know that area, Western Pennsylvania, Northeast Ohio, Delaware, down to Maryland, good high school football program.
Well, the issue he's going to have is if they're playing in the Big 12, so many of their games are going to be in Texas and Oklahoma and no longer a drive to places like Rutgers.
Right.
Even Louisville, Cincinnati, Syracuse in the conference. So what will the base of recruiting be? Holgorsen has a lot of great ties in the state of Texas where they do so much of the 7-on-7 year-long pitch-and-catch football that has become predominant college football, the high school level in those camps during the summer and right here. Paul Millard, the number two quarterback, standing on this drive. Flip it over to Clemson and Dabo Swinney. Jaws mentioned in the first half all the recruiting that they have done very successfully. Matter of fact, there was a point a few years ago where Dabo had been involved in the recruitment of nearly half of the scholarship players that Clemson had. He's a phenomenal recruiter, sends a great message, and has really improved the image of Clemson football, which Tommy Bowden was doing before when Dabo was on his staff and replaced him as the interim coach middle of the 08 season. So despite this major disappointment tonight, this is a program that's in the right direction as they head to 2012. They open up with Auburn in the Georgia Dome to start next season. That pass is incomplete. Through the hands of Coley White.
Well, White had a chance to make a catch. Obviously disappointed. Coach Holgorsen gives him a pat on the back. If that had been a meaningful play, it would have been a pat on the back.
Not from Dana Holgorsen.
No,
who's been
it would have been.
Rip a player or two,
yeah.
Fire back his sugar-free Red Bulls during the game. He said,
I like this guy. I do.
He said he uses that to get his energy, but he said he also he's a coffee drinker like every other football coach under the sun, it seems. Punt away from Corey Smith, and the big rush forced him to get rid of it quick. It's only a 17-yard punt. Marty Aronoff tells us. Our spotter Mike Black hands me the card to remind you of Arkansas State, future home of Gus Malzahn as head coach, taking on Northern Illinois, the GoDaddy.com Bowl, last bowl before the championship game. So Sunday night, 9 Eastern, after you bang around watching NFL action, the playoffs, get a chance to watch one more game. Get ready for Monday night, Arkansas State at Northern Illinois.
New quarterback, Cole Stout.
True freshman, Stout handing to Roderick McDowell. As the backups come in, and McDowell gets thrown down by Keith Tandy.
That's form tackling right there. You see, I mentioned Cole Stout in the game. His dad, Cliff Stout, has a number of Super Bowl rings from backing up Terry Bradshaw with the Pittsburgh Steelers. Also a quarterback I recruited at Youngstown State back in the early 70s. What a lineage here.
Here with Miami, played with the Cardinals as well as McDowell. The sophomore takes it out of bounds with 2:21 to go.
Believe Cole Stout, Dublin, Ohio, same high school Brady Quinn went to.
Yep.
And Boyd struggled tonight, clearly in the second half. A lot of turnovers that really doomed Clemson. I think it's wise to get Stout some playing time, Ron.
I agree with you, John.
True freshman took 65 snaps in five games. Just handing here. Again, it's McDowell out of Sumter, South Carolina. Mentioned Stout breaking those Brady Quinn records at Kauffman High School in Dublin. Nearly 4,400 yards and 52 touchdowns. Most of the ranking services had him as a quarterback in the mid-20s coming out. A little bit of game experience his freshman year, and he'll head into spring ball and see a significant more time. Pass incomplete. Just sad time for the Clemson fans. They had hoped to relive the glory of this game 30 years ago, played in the original Orange Bowl Stadium, the only national championship won by Clemson. Danny Ford, the coach, very young coach back in 1981.
Had a cup of coffee with Danny Ford today. Coach Ford looking great. Still farming out in South Carolina.
Farming?
Yep.
Yep. Yeah, very cool.
Big farmer. Stout taking off. He'll come down five. Right near that first down, 1:22 to go.
And again, I go back, Mike, to these fifth-year seniors at West Virginia who've been through three different head coaches. What an exclamation point on their careers. Guys like Julian Miller.
Goal run for McDowell for the corner. And that takes us over 100 points in the game here tonight.
Did you say over 100 points, Mike?
Yes.
Wow.
0-2, still 21 shy of the Baylor-Washington game. Just put up 123 the other night.
We talked about this pedal to the metal, high volume offense by both teams. West Virginia's run 87 plays and Clemson 74. Boy, these teams just pile up the yards with offensive plays.
Yeah, 161 points, over 1,000 yards.
Yeah, they're there sneaking up. They're sneaking up.
That's what I like. It's Lyman, Barkley, the left tackle, guys that can handle the Gatorade properly. There's Raider, the other tackle.
Set the screen for him, and go Golden get him.
Said, got him.
It's a great moment. Great moment for West Virginia.
And they love football there. Just look there at those fans, Mike. Yeah. A lot of West Virginia fans that made this trip are still bunched together. They're thrilled with Dana Holgorsen and the outcome of this bowl game. Look at those fans. They're not leaving. They're going to stay for the last minute and one.
Yeah, they're going to get that trophy presentation.
Reese Davis will be doing that down on the field here.
I hope they're celebrating right next to your room tonight. You know, Danny's.
You'll see the trophy presentation on the Ford BCS postgame show coming up next.
You're relentless.
You're on ESPN. they are great fans. Many a trip down to Morgantown. Some backyard brawls, watched some terrific football games and players over the years. We mentioned Don Nealon, West Virginia coach for a long time. We're going to get Jeff Castile now. Yeah, we got the defensive coordinator as well. A little pooch kick. It's a live ball, but knocked out of bounds. Rashad Breeland went tumbling looking for the ball. He gets up okay. And who knows if Jeff Castile will be joining Rich Rodriguez at Arizona. You'll hear all that moving and shaking over the next few days or so. But no matter what, his 3-3-5 defense and the defensive effort as a whole by West Virginia. Yep. So very good. Stumped the quarterback Boyd tonight.
Pretty hard to leave this West Virginia program right now. Looks pretty darn good. It's really ascending.
I agree with you.
The Big East for all the lumps the Big East takes over the years. The Big East has represented itself far better than the ACC in these BCS games. ACC going to fall to 2-13 in BCS games.
Geno Smith returns to Miami, where he played high school football, with a 70.6 touchdown night. He couldn't script it any better.
Last snap in the books. And if it is the Mountaineers' farewell to the Big East, they do it with a bang. And Dana Holgerson's very unique route to his first ever season as a head coach ends on a very high platform. A bowl record 70 points scored by the Mountaineers on a night where the team and a lot of the individuals rewrite the record books of one of the oldest and most tradition-rich bowls in the sport. Clemson's season will end at 10-4. And here's Lisa Salters with the victorious head coach.
Thanks, Mike. Coach, 70 points you put up on the board, a bowl record. How did you make it look so easy? First, were you going for the record?
No. Hey, there's nothing easy about that now. Clemson's a great team. They've had an unbelievable year. You know, our guys just came in, and I think we're playing a little bit better when our backs are against the wall. Not too many people gave us credit, and the guys wanted to come in and kind of make a statement, which, and the only way you can do that is if you play on all three sides of the ball.
How could you tell that your tempo was hurting them?
Well, it's been an emphasis for us. You know, we've had a hard time all year getting the tempo going, and it's dangerous to get it. It's dangerous to tempo if you're not being very good with it. And we just kind of emphasized it here over the course of the last 15 practices and got better at it.
What impact did that fumble recovery return for a touchdown have on the game?
Yeah, that amplified what we've been telling them for the last 2 months, which is regardless what happens, just keep playing. And defense gave up a long drive, but they just kept playing. And they ended up getting a turnover on the goal line, which turned the game.
And the guys are still trying to figure out that one play that was so successful for multiple touchdowns. It's recorded as a pass, but it kind of looks as a volleyball, kind of tap, toss. What is that?
Well, my good friend Bob Stead at Colorado School of the Mines gave me that, which basically it's you know, we toss it to him, and if we drop it, it's an incomplete pass. So it's actually a safe play.
What message do you want to send with this win tonight? 70 points again, Coach.
Well, just, you know, the seniors have done such a good job all year long. They were put in a bad situation. They've been through a lot in their career at West Virginia. And, you know, they just wanted to lay the groundwork for where we're headed as a football program. And, you know, I can't imagine it being any brighter than it is right now. I think the future is pretty bright at West Virginia.
Thank you, and congratulations to you, Coach.
Thank you, Lee.
Mike.
All right, all you coaches, we clinic out at the Colorado School of Mines. It's a great-looking play. A little bit off of Lee Grosskopf's old shovel pass at Utah with a great wrinkle. And performed to perfection on a night, as our friend Tony Caridi likes to say, it's great to be a Mountaineer.